Special thanks to Jitendra Giri, sir, the speaker for today, as well as the head of the department for the fashion. I would also like to thank Subhash Paul, who is the host for today. He is from the Advise International Business Development Manager from Advise International team, currently overseeing the marketing team. So I'll just introduce the speaker for today, Jitendra Giri, sir. Jitendra, sir, specializes in fashion, illustration, and surface or ornamentation, having worked as a senior designer at Gitanjali Group with top brands like Dia and Giri, and faculty at VCIC, Vishwakarma Creative College, Pune. Jitendra, sir, is an anxious asset for his team and publicized the mentor. MSc in textile with first merit certificate from Amravati University and diploma from Lord's Academy, Nagpur. Jitendra, sir, has knack for the values education. He believes being glamorous and about his strength and confidence. Sir, I'll just pass on to you, and Subhash, can you just take this forward? Thank you so much.
So very good afternoon from all of us from Advise. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So to all of the students joining us live on Facebook and Instagram, a very good afternoon from all of us from Advise International and the team. It's a pleasure to go live at this point of time and interview a personality, head of department from the fashion department of the Atharva College of Fashion from Mumbai. So, sir, this is a small event of around 40-45 minutes, where we just want to know about the future of the industry, the career opportunities, and your thoughts around the industry. So I would be the host for the day. Yeah. I will ask you a few questions, and you could just enlighten all of us with your experience and knowledge, sir.
Sure.
Yeah. So a little bit about you, sir, before we start, you know, something about you and your college. If you could let us know, please.
Yeah. So basically, I'm working here from the last 5 years, and I am heading this department, Atharva School of Fashion and Arts. And we have a team of 10 faculties, and we have things like a good classroom, and there are good innovative technologies in our college. So yes,
great. So yep. Just coming to the industry, fashion industry altogether. A very basic question, if I would say that, how has it impacted because of the pandemic? Last 18 months or more than that,
we were hit by a pandemic. It impacted very much, I can say, because there are many things in fashion where, you know, we need fabric, we need raw material. So basically, the industries which is from Surat or other where we get from a raw material, they stop their product. They're not supplying their material. And so, yes, so the concern was like the main designers or the small scale industries from the small areas or towns, they have been closed or they have been, you know, not working. They have stopped working because of they are not getting suppliers, those who used to supply fabric or any kind of raw material. So impacted very much because even we don't have a labor, stitching labors or karagir we say. So we don't have because everyone has gone to their hometown. They don't have any salary. They don't have any job. And they were not assured when will the companies will start or the small industry will start. So yes, there was a lot of impact of COVID on fashion.
Yeah, yes, that's yes, very evident. Yes, sir. Now, sir, in terms of the education, fashion colleges, I would say, or the universities or schools which provide this course or you know this program. Are we going to see some changes in the future, sir, in terms of the course content?
Yes, there will be a lot of changes in the course content because, you know, there are a lot of things are coming, new things are coming. So there are, you know, fashion sustainability. This is booming now. Organic fashion is booming now. So as for that, people are changing their mindset regarding the passion. So definitely there will be changes in study also, like in way of learning passion. So people will go to organic passion, moreover.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. So I'll come back to this question again, but probably before the pandemic, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, probably Italy or probably London, they are, and they were considered as the fashion hub of the world, right?
Yeah.
So how has it changed after the pandemic? Is there any change in that? Any new destinations coming up?
There is not a lot of change. Because see, the market is now running, it's not going to stop anywhere. Like as you say, there was a break, but there are like, you know, if and buts in each and every sector. So yes, Italy, they are still a fashion hub. Paris still is a fashion hub. So they must have affected because of pandemic, yes, but they have started their life and their fashion industry again.
Okay, great. Sir, during this pandemic, every individual, whether it was a small kid from a school or it was a college graduate student or a working professional like me, we all connected virtually, probably Zoom and other platforms. And education industry implemented, inculcate quite a bit of technical stuff, right? Now, will these technical changes will be still seen even after the pandemic? Will schools and colleges still adapt to these changes, or we are going to go like quite a bit of, you know, face to face classes and all that?
See, actually, the thing is that like there are many things in online study, but whereas regarding fashion, if you ask me, or any art field, if you ask me, it will be better if it's face to face because. People are means like fashion students. They are more of practical. Means they have daily practicals. Whether it's illustration, whether it's garment technology, whether it's embroidery. So basically, they have to come and take learning from a faculty or a teacher, where they will come and learn from the particular that each stream. So thing is that when it comes to e-learning or online for a fashion, I don't think so. It's a proper thing because many of my students also they said teacher like they are paying so much of what do you say fees and all. So they said like if we want to give this much fees, so why we will learn in college? So basically we will go to some online stuff like. There are many channels, there are many social sites, e-networking sites where they can learn fashion or any art kind of thing.
Great.
So this, I will say like face-to-face is the better option for practical subjects.
Absolutely. This might be a very basic question, but since we are live on FB and probably Insta, yes, there are a lot of other students, probably students from 11th and 12th, or parents who are, you know, watching this live now.
Yes.
So, wanted to ask you, although this might be a very basic question for you, how important really is a portfolio for any student who wants to take admissions, either in India or abroad, for a master's in design, or even for that matter of fact, an undergraduate course in design?
I see, portfolio is basically, it's undergraduate. When you are like doing a graduation in fashion industry, that time you make up your portfolio. With the portfolio is important when you go to industry. It's like when you want a job or if you are going to some good designer, well-known designer, and if they ask you a portfolio, so definitely that's a very basic thing which you carry with you. Without that, the person can't judge the student or that particular person who is going for a job or interview or any kind of, you know, interaction. So first thing that comes with the student is portfolio. So it's very important for a fashion industry.
Yeah. So as I've been saying, there might be students from non-fashion background, you know, attending today, your parents. Generally, what should be a basic portfolio like, you know, especially for students who would like to study further? Like, you know, what should be the basic ingredients of a portfolio?
See, if you are you're saying there are some students who are like from not from a fashion industry, so might be they will not understand this term.
Absolutely.
The portfolio. So it's like it should have everything. I'm like how they have think about their team. So it starts from very kind of zero kind of thing. Like when you are making your portfolio, on what structure you are making your portfolio, on what theme you are making your portfolio, what subject you have taken. So basically, you should choose some kind of subject where, you know, it should be very innovative, out of the box, where you can show your creation. And the basic things, it's a day-to-day life wearing, or it's just for a walk or a ramp or for a fashion show, where you can't wear those kind of non-wearable, if you say, kind of design. So that kind of portfolios are different. And so students has to make a portfolio where it has a very, you know, clean, and where the person can understand the theme after seeing one.
Absolutely, yes, sir. That's right, yeah. So, as an example, if a student is doing a business course, like a BBA or BBM, mm-hmm. or a marketing course in India, mm-hmm. now, okay, undergraduate mm-hmm. course. Mm-hmm. So, along with that traditional degree, there is always mm-hmm. a buzzword now that you should always do upgrade your skills, right? Probably Correct. Someone might do a small course in digital marketing, small Correct. Course in data analytics, etc. Similarly, Correct. For a traditional mm-hmm. fashion or design course, university mm-hmm. course, mm-hmm. what should a student be doing more to upgrade his skills or her skills?
See, now
different these kind of courses could be done.
Yeah, there are a lot of competitions, and new courses have been introduced in the fashion industry. So there is a styling, there is a merchandising, visual merchandising. So there are many waves have like these are open for the fashion student. There is a fashion photography, fashion editor, there is a fashion blogger. So I will suggest when you are doing such degree, but while doing a degree or any kind of course, if it's a certificate course or something like that course, you should choose your career wisely. Means like if you are interested in doing styling, so that particular student should after some period, like when you get to know the basic of the fashion, means like illustration, embroidery, or any kind of garment technology. So once you are getting interested in some particular subject, so that particular student should have, you know, get knowledge of that particular thing only, while getting everything in a one bucket only. Like, mujhe ye bhi karna hai, mujhe wo bhi karna hai. Means like, I want to do this, I want to do that. No. Means like, think about one thing. Okay, I want to do fashion styling. So definitely after my graduation, I will find such course where, you know, where I will get only styling lectures, or where I'll get only styling preparations under any designer or under any institute where they are only running such courses as only other than the basic university course.
Okay, great.
So, so they are not a very long period. They must be 6 months or 3 months or 1 year course.
Okay, yeah. But you do suggest that along with the traditional degree, they should do some these kind of small courses that will definitely enhance their career, right?
Yeah, because see, in this degree courses, we gave everything in a year wise, but that too for six months.
Absolutely.
But if you particular go for one course, that will be for 3 months, 6 months, or 1 year. So it will be, you know, just a one subject. There you can get hammer that particular thing to a student. Okay, there are styling lectures, styling project, and styling assignment. So that particular thing, students will get to know, okay, this is my subject, garment technology. So they will take pattern making, cutting, stitching, different patterns, different cutting things. So that will be a one line to a student where he can take his career to that particular thing.
Great. Now, sir, and I don't know if there's a buzzword in the college, artificial intelligence everywhere. I've been visiting a lot of college campuses and AI is a buzzword everywhere. And I just want to find out in your college or what is this, how is AI going to be used in fashion industry in the future? Is it used now? Would you just like to, you know, enlighten us about this, please?
Actually, I didn't get your question because I don't think so. In my college, there is some AI kind of thing.
So what I'm saying is that artificial intelligence is going to take quite a bit of jobs and quite a bit of new roles, job roles, occupations have come around artificial intelligence, right? So is the fashion industry impacted by any way because of AI, because of artificial intelligence? Is there any change we will see sometime in the future?
No, see, their fashion will change each and every time. Like we say in a fashion, fashion has a cycle.
Absolutely, yes.
So that particular cycle, there will be a lot of changes every 10 years or every 5 years, as you see in the market, like how people used to wear bell bottoms in our father time. But yes, we also used it in after long period. But yes, it will come after maybe one generation or something like that. So it's a cycle. There will be a lot of things. So I don't think so that AI will be any kind of harmful or that will affect the market of fashion.
In the current content or the syllabus or the curriculum that whatever we teach in our university degree courses in fashion or art and design, you as a head of a department, what would you reckon and what changes you would like to see in the next 2-3 years?
There are some Indian colleges, they are very good. As per the Indian market, there are a lot of international schools of designs are coming. So definitely there will be a lot of things, and India will be the one of the best fashion hub, you will say, in the upcoming years. Because, you know, it's not like that. There are only typical courses are running in colleges. In our college also, we are running advanced courses. So there are a lot of advanced courses coming in other cities also. So they are, you know, getting knowledge about the fashion and new technologies or education in, regarding the fashion industry. So definitely there will be a lot of things in fashion.
It's always, right from the time when I was in school, you know, if I'm good in drawing and painting, probably the elders would have not appreciated that. They would have said, okay, you know, what is the monetary benefit in the future? We don't know. You should be an engineer or you should work as a doctor or scientist and earn money. So not many, at least in my generation, our elders or our parents were not very keen on, focusing or telling us to be art and design graduate or work, have a career in the field of art and design. Is that trend changed now, sir, in this generation now?
Yes, because from 100%, 90% people are changed, but 10% people are the same. Some people, they don't think this art or fashion thing, they are meant for a good manner or for a good sense or something like that. Means like they have a typical mindset. If it's fashion or so people will walk on a short dresses and something like that. And if it regarding art, yes, arts, there are many parents, they have changed their mindset because their parents wanted to be, you know, the competitive world, because each and every one can't be a doctor. Absolutely. He can't be an engineer.
Absolutely.
So parents, they know how much capability of my child is capable. So as per that only they choose their career, and yes, they do very well if they choose art also.
Yeah, since we are into overseas education, just want to ask you, you know, obviously foreign land, foreign countries, there's so much of fashion, right? The Western world with its New York or London and, you know, all these big cities. So, how do you see, like, you know, our students going and studying abroad? And I'm sure quite a bit of your students from Mumbai or your contacts have already gone and study abroad. How is generally their experience when they go and study abroad? We like to just, you know, enlighten.
Yes, there is a lot of different studies, and it's like I will say they have very advanced and they have very focused things regarding fashion. Means as I told you before also, like in 3 years or this 4 years degree course for six months, we teach each and everything. Means like each and every subject that illustration goes to. Means like first the basic drawing, then drawing, and second term it goes to illustration subject, then it goes to portfolio subject, where you get, you know, like in that 3-4 years you get slowly upward direction. But in foreign countries, it's not like that. They take one subject and they study on that particular subject only, and they make their career in that particular thing. So, there are a lot of difference. Means like it's like if you're getting graduate in 3 years here in India. So, yes, in international market, means like international education-wise, you get... in 1 year, you are a graduate. That's compared. So, just 1 year course is equal to 3 year course in India.
Oh, okay. It's quite focused. It's like quite specific and focused.
Yes.
So, obviously, since you're the head of a department of a respected and reputed school, from a fashion school, from college, from Mumbai, I'm sure your networks and your contacts, you must have seen so many students who have gone abroad and studied and all. Just want to ask you, what is the general trend according to you, since you're in a big city, you're in a metro city in Mumbai, what is the trend to which countries generally students would go to study a art and design or a fashion course generally?
Generally, it's Italy, because they have very lot of fashion institutes or colleges. Means like if they don't have colleges, like big colleges, like, you know, with the 100 rooms or 400, it's like kind of, they have so many big technology. They have was just a small one room, in that only they are running their institute, and they are giving a full pledge to a student. Like, okay, this is a fashion, so they have to make a career in this. So they have their time set, they have their limit. So it's just a 1 month program. So that will be, you know, like 10 to 6. So once the student gets in at 10 o'clock, he will go out by 6 o'clock. So there is just a 10-minute or 15-minute lunch break in that only. And if you're late, like for if you're coming on 10 and 5 minutes late in the class, so there is no entry in such class, and that student particularly, you have to attend that class. And there will be no repeat subject. Means like whatever that they have taught in that particular day, it won't be repeated again. That student has to learn his own whenever he is going for a next lecture. So it's that different.
Great. Quite a bit of quality. Your students who have been abroad, or who you're in contact with, how about their jobs, and, you know, do they have their own businesses, or what is the trend generally?
I will not say about their jobs or like, yeah, but there is a lot of changes in them career-wise. They have growth very well. They must have doing some particular jobs or some business, because some of them, they are still studying. They are pursuing some studies. But yes, definitely, there are a lot of changes in there. What I have seen them when they came to me, or like, you know, I know them. But today, they are on a very up level, upgraded level.
Oh, great. All right. It enhances the personality and communication.
Personality,
and confidence.
Correct. Yes.
Absolutely. Okay. So there are quite a bit of students. Anyone who would like to ask a question, please, if you're on Zoom, I think you can just raise your hands, or you can simply chat with the host or co-host. I think sir also is a host, a co-host. I am the co-host with a couple of my colleagues. So mm-hmm. if you have a question, because we are talking to a head of department of Atharva College of Fashion and Arts. So, you know, this conversation would definitely help you. So if you have any questions that you always wanted to ask, please do type it for us. If it comes to me, I will ask it. Otherwise, some of my colleagues might just unmute and ask the question, or it might go to sir. Alternately, you can raise hands also. For students or others who are on Facebook or Instagram, if you would also like to ask a question, please send us a message and we'll be happy to, you know, ask your questions to sir. So by the behind the scenes, and so by the time I'm getting the question, sir, it just, you know, as we're coming to the mm-hmm. conclusion, you know, in terms of the fashion industry or the art and design industry, mm-hmm. is in this industry also quite a bit of technology, because it's all creative, right? It's art, it's fine arts, all creativity.
Yes. Yes.
Is this industry also touched quite a bit by technology by any chance, or how is it like? I'm just asking as a layman, you know.
Yes,
not
yes,
from
yes,
the
yes, yes, yes. A lot of changes, like technology is there in the fashion industry as well. Like as you say, there are big industries where, you know, where what pattern we make. So there are like computerized pattern maker now. We have got it. Then there were like, first we used to do embroideries on a single machine. But there are computer embroidery machines where, you know, 100 of sample sets can be designed or made at a one time. So there is a lot of technology coming in fashion also. There are laser cutting, laser markers. Yes, there are technologies which is affecting, means like they are developing fashion industry as well.
Great. Yeah. So I was also reading the other day about this AR and VR, augmented reality and virtual reality.
Correct.
Marks and Spencer,
yes.
You know, they have some kind of graphics on the t-shirts of children, like a giraffe or a tiger. And because of this AR and VR technologies, this mm-hmm. can actually come to life.
Correct.
So this is pretty interesting, isn't it? So, you know, coming towards the end, like sustainability in the fashion world.
Mm-hmm.
How much of importance is it given to it now, and how is it going there?
See, it's very booming now because people are going towards, as I said, organic fashion or sustainability. Because, you know, as per seeing the nature, means like what we are affecting to our nature, and there are a lot of things which we use in making fabric also. So there is elastic plastic we use by making this synthetic fabric. So people are getting knowing that that even our what we are wearing, the t-shirt we are wearing, that is also harmful to our nature. So people are going towards sustainability and organic fashions, where they are choosing cotton thing, or which are not, means like not much synthetic stuff can be used that will not affect our nature. So yes, sustainability will be, people will always accept that, and they will accept it because somewhere even we are harming, saying the fashion. So harming people, it's an alarming time. So people are definitely will love it. Going to sustainable fashion.
Great. All right. Okay. That's amazing, sir. As I'm getting other questions, Atharva College offers undergraduate courses in arts and fashion, also fine arts and all.
No, we have certification courses. Definitely, but we are planning to take undergraduate courses very soon because. Because of this pandemic, we didn't get opportunities to, you know, talk to some good universities and all. But yes, definitely, we are going to do it very soon.
Okay, so I've got a couple of questions in my inbox. So we're just going to take some questions quickly. And I know it's almost three. We will try and wind it up. This question from a young student asking about students in 12th standard and wanting to pursue a course in art and design. Mm-hmm. So what are the career prospects? A very simple question.
See, thing is that like even 10th out passing student also can join the course. In arts and design, whether it's fashion designing or whether it's any other kind of digital art or there are many things like graphic designing art. But he or she should be very much focused on his career or aim. It's not like that. It's an easy thing. Okay, drawing it to nikalna hai. Okay, sketching it to karna hai. It's not like that. You have to give your 100% to that particular subject. Then only you can make your career in a good manner, in a fashion also. It's not only the, it's a very easy thing. We will go and learn all this fashion thing and we will get the job. It's not like that. You have to be on a floor 24/7 when you're this industry or any other industry, like, fashion and art design, I'm saying.
Great. So, student has asked, what is a, how would be robots, cutting fabrics is something that we have heard. So the student has asked, he or she has heard about robots being used in some foreign lands to cut and sew fabrics. So is it true? And do you know anything about it? I don't know if you could be able to answer this question.
I have not heard about this. Robots are cutting
fabrics
and something like that. Yeah, but there is a technology which is, coming, means already there, where you can do it with the laser thing. So that is very much helpful and very easy way.
Absolutely.
Than cutting a robot, because you have to give a means like that function to that robot particularly. But yes, it's the same system like laser. So maybe, but I have not heard about it.
Yes.
Maybe I am lacking about this thing. So maybe I should ask that Absolutely. Particular student, send me that particular link or something like that where I can study,
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. So I think we would take this as a last question.
Okay.
3D printing, is it going to affect the fashion industry in any way, 3D printing?
It's not going. I mean, it's like 3D printing is a very different thing. It's now it's going to come, in the market. There are many people, they don't know about the 3D printing also. But yes, there are some people, institute or some colleges or some industry where they are planning to take this 3D printing in market. So right now, though, it's not gone to very common people. Those who belong to fashion industries or well-known, they know the fashion very well. Only they know this 3D printing. But common people, I don't think so. They must be knowing about this 3D printing.
Absolutely, yes. Yeah. Although it's a billion-dollar industry for the future, but then we'll wait and watch and see. Yes, it could be having its own implementation or application in the industry. Yeah. But not very prevalent at the moment, but yeah, it's something big that is coming. Yes, great. So, sir, before we conclude, your any thoughts about advice? If you could say something about advice, if you have been knowing about us or you have seen or read about
advice, I am knowing about more than 6 months, I think. But yes, they are doing a very good job regarding giving opportunities to students to knowing about the any kind of industry. It's just not a fashion. Maybe it's engineering, maybe it's a hotel management, or maybe any kind of things like in education world. But yes, advisors giving a very good platform to a student to know a particular subject or a particular any kind of where even the parents, they don't know what career I should choose. Yes, but the advice they are giving a very good platform to students and their parents to know about that particular industry. And yes, you guys are doing very good job to make this student career for the future and all.
Great. Yeah, it is a pleasure for me to share, sir, that we completed 30 years as an organization. So we're a 30 years young company.
Yeah.
And we have helped thousands of students in these 30 years.
That's and, great. That's great.
Yeah. So it is a pleasure that, you know, we could talk to you,
yes,
get to know your thoughts about fashion and career and occupations. And I know there are, this topic is never ending. We could keep on talking, but I know we all have a time limit. And, you know, it was wonderful to listen to your thoughts, sir. Good.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure of mine. Thank you so much for giving me this platform
to
share my views. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'll see you next time sometime. Thank you so much.
Yes, goodbye.
All of you joining from Facebook, Instagram, and also on Zoom, thank you so much for attending this small talk. I hope you have made the most of it. If you have any questions, please do come back to us. Just log in on our website, adviseinternational.com, and you can connect to any one of us. My name is Subhash, signing off for today. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Jidin, sir. Thank you for your time. Thank you, Mrs. Lopa, ma'am. Thank you, Subhash. Have a nice day to everyone and students. Special thanks to you, those who participated from Akula College also and from Atharva College of Fashion. Thank you so much. Signing off, Gaurav Khurana here from marketing team. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, students. Thank you, sir.